There are just 3 days left of Northeast Conference games, and the regular season title is still up for grabs. Tonight, two first-place teams, Monmouth and St. Francis, New York, meet in the most important showdown of the year. If the Hawks win, they'll clinch the number one seed in next week's conference tournament. If the Terriers emerge victorious, they'll take over sole possession of the top spot in the league standings. Coming up, 40 minutes of hoop intensity with first place on the line. Don't miss all the action. Next. Tonight's game is sold out. The Jersey Shore is abuzz with their Monmouth Hawks. Buckle up. Live from Boylan Gymnasium in West Long Branch, New Jersey, this is Northeast Conference Basketball on MSG. Crail to Boxler for the jam.
Monmouth attacked that time, Dave. They're just not going to be satisfied with just getting it over half court. Once they get it over half court, they're going to exploit their opportunities that time. Beautiful two-on-one play. I like their attitude, though. They're not just satisfied, Dave. They're getting up and making plays like that.
Second dunk, this one for Blake Hamilton. And Chris Kenny, Mr. Microwave, in off the bench, along with Marcus Alston, a couple of Jersey Shore kids, Kenny from CBA, and Alston from Neptune.
Jason Crail, beautiful acceleration from the middle of the floor.
Byfield attacking, kicks it out to Kenny.
For three! You're going to retreat. If you're going to press, you got to get back, and you better locate Chris Kenny. This is interesting. Hamilton only with one shot so far in the first 10 minutes of play. He's the guy that had 29 in the first game.
Marcus Alston with the right hand. St. Francis leads it by three. Byfield, a long one.
Got it! Byfield getting into the act from downtown. Also, the both teams are ready.
An exciting first half, 8:38 left in the first. Backdoor pass to Kaplan, textbook Monmouth offense.
Credit Ducky Delish with a beautiful pass to Tom Kaplan. The substitute's coming in and executing some good offense off the high post. Shuffle cut, great vision.
St. Francis, 7 out of 12 from three-point range, and Monmouth at 50%. Delish
drains it! He had it to set himself in rhythm. Decky Delish, good offense. There's enough time left for St. Francis to continue to play good solid defense, especially with their three-point shooting ability, but that's an open shot.
Azzarelli, a two-point bucket, 4 points, his first field goal.
That was great execution. Monmouth really worked the clock around. All five players touched the basketball. Then Azzarelli, known as a setup guy, was left open. And he's played great on the defensive end, but right there answered with a big-time jump shot.
Kaplan makes it a four-point game. And Kaplan with 11 points off the bench. His final home game, make it 12. 87-82 Mama. Cavalieri, and that will do it. And the Monmouth students storm the court as the Hawks go undefeated at home in the Northeast Conference this year, a perfect 12-0. Final score, Monmouth 87, St. Francis 82. And Monmouth clinches the number one seed in this year's NEC tournament.
Can't see nothing in front of me. Can't see nothing coming up behind. Make my way through this darkness. I can't feel nothing but this chain that binds me. Lost track of how far I've gone. How far I've gone, how high I've climbed. On the backs of 60-pound stone. On the shoulder half mile of line. Come on up for the rising. Come on up and lay your hands in line. Come on up for the rising. Come on up for the rising. see Mary in the garden. In the garden of the thousand sighs, those holy pictures of the children dancing in the sky, filled with light. May you feel your arms around me. May you feel your blood mixed with mine. The dream of life comes to me like a catfish dancing on the end of my line. The sky of blackness and sorrow.
To the land of Bruce Springsteen. We're in West Long Branch, New Jersey, along the shore for the NEC Championship. Keep an eye on him, Frail, underneath.
Yes,
got the first points of the game.
Execution of special situations. They will play 10 players in the first 12 minutes of this game.
A lot of folks, nice backdoor cut. The thing that's great about these small conferences, Hamilton loses his footing. Here's Anderson going in, tough shot, got it to go. Russell Anderson averaging just under 5 a game on 43% shooting, 6-2 Monmouth. Back to Crail. Backfield now, Hamilton going right at Robinson, and he scores. He took it right to him. Very impressive performance by Hamilton on that one. 8-2 start.
In terms of depth, advantage for Monmouth.
Azzarelli in the back cut. And a 10-2 start by Monmouth. You bet. Timeout. Central Connecticut State. A great start. Monmouth shooting 5-for-7. Central Connecticut 1-of-7 from the field. Looking around the perimeter. Byfield will go up top to Hamilton. Let him operate on. Robinson steps in.
Oh.
Finger rolls go. He's got 4. Azzarelli at 6, he's in trouble, gets a shot of it, in. Oh my goodness.
The force is with them at home.
Fast moving half, approaching 3 minutes to go. Fade away, Byfield got it that time. Back on top is Monmouth. This half has been a blur. Can we just start back? Cut, Azzarelli scores again! 3-point opportunity!
With their leading player on the bench, they're holding tight here.
Frail, runner down the right lane.
Senior time. Boxler on the high post, Hamilton. Foul trouble in the first half, he's in there now.
Boxler, the big man, 6'11", stepping outside. Nowhere to go, Azzarelli checks shot clock. He'll step back, change of direction, nifty! Very nifty, Tyler Azzarelli by 10.
More comfortable when you're the home team.
No doubt about it. Byfield, pull up. They are on fire. He's got 6.
One-on-one guy, Dave. Every time Robinson touches it, they double. You're hitting him. They let him go one-on-one.
Robinson hasn't had a touch about the last three, four possessions. Oh, that's a big one. Chris Kenny for three.
Mojica trying to get something going.
Taken down by Anderson.
Blue collar, huh? Isn't he? Love that Anderson. Doing a great job in this game.
Made Wadiki look pretty bad on that one. Ugly shot. Hamilton throws it down with the right hand as he chased down the miss.
Notice how all four players on the perimeter can all handle the basketball and pass and cut.
Backdoor cut layup.
Wadiki can open up the bag and put that title in it right now.
Say more about my teammates. I mean, we held each other down all year, and then they came out. Tyler Azzarelli had the biggest game of his life. Everybody played defense, everybody on the team. I only had 6 points. We held down the player of the year because we're the team of the year. Team of the year in the Northeast Conference. And that's all that matters to me.
All of your friends are saying out here they want Duke. Who do you want in the first round?
Not Duke.
He's no dummy. He's got a 3.8 GPA.
This year, it seems to be a different mindset. We won our regular season championship. We were the one seed in our conference tournament. We went through our tournament, won all three games by double digits, went undefeated at home. And I really sense from our players that this time around, there's the sort of the attitude of we want to prove to people we belong here.
We were cheering for Manhattan since they're underdog and they're from the similar area, but I think it gives us a lot of motivation to go out there and play our hearts out because, I mean, they just beat an SAT team, a very big team. And I think we can do the same if we come in there and play our game.
People, you know, just people from my area and from all over have decided to come out and they're going to support us and I guess be Monmouth fans for the night. So we'll see how that goes. But I think it's great that so many people are going to be able to come and watch me play.
Our kids really enjoy being at Monmouth. They're basketball players, but they're students first, and that's what Monmouth is all about. We have 9 guys on our team that are above 3.0 students. Our average GPA is 2.95.
I was definitely prepared to go at a different level, but at the same fact, I got put in a very good position. My high school coach is very good friends with the assistant coach here, Coach Calzanetti, so It was really good that he got me out here. I got to meet new guys, and it was a really nice school, so I made the right choice. It was late, but I made the right choice.
It's a great situation in Monmouth. We understand what we're about. It's a great university. I love being there, and our kids love being there, and this is a chance for our university to be on the grand stage and for our players to play in a national tournament. You can't ask for anything more than that.
I truly think that they're ready to play, they're ready to give their best, and I think we'll be proud of how they perform.
Well, I'm one of a couple of hundred people from Monmouth University that's really excited about being here. There are all kinds of folks here. You can hear the pep band in the background. The cheerleaders are here. There are alums, there are trustees, there are friends of Monmouth University. It's going to be a great night. We're all excited. This is the Monmouth family. This is what athletics is about, is drawing everybody on the campus together to have a great experience that everybody can share in.
Thank you. We're getting to